hard and soft water. Water is an excellent solvent. Rainwater is the pure form of water. When it falls on the earth, different salts dissolves in it and it becomes hard water. So water is of two types. First one, hard water. Hard water contains calcium and magnesium salts in the form of bicarbonates, chlorides and sulfates. Okay, and it does not produce any lather with the soap. Example, seawater. Next, soft water. It is the pure form of water. It does not contain any soluble salts like salts of calcium and magnesium, bicarbonate, chlorides and sulfate. It's free from all the salts. Okay, it gives lather with the soap. Example, distilled water and rainwater. Okay. Effects of hard water. Hard water is unsuitable for laundry because soap contains potassium and sodium salts of long chain fatty acids. That is, soap is sodium stearate. C70H35COONA. That is sodium stearate. Okay. When it dissolves in hard water, what happens? It forms a precipitate. Okay. Or we can say scum. That is M2+. This is a salt, calcium or magnesium salt present in the hard water. It reacts with soap. C70H35COONA. Okay, and this gets converted to +2Na+. This is metal stearate. It's a precipitate, or we can say scum. This is a precipitate. It gets precipitated. So soap will not produce any lather in hard water. This is the first effect. Next, second effect, harmful for boilers. It is harmful for boilers. If hard water is used in boilers, it reduces its efficiency. Okay, that is because of the deposition of salts in the form of scale. Okay, different salts are deposited in the form of scale takes place. So this is harmful for hard water, is harmful for boilers. Okay. Types of hardness. Hardness are of two types. First one, temporary hardness. Temporary hardness. This is due to the presence of calcium and magnesium in the form of bicarbonates. Okay, that is due to the bicarbonates of calcium and magnesium. Okay, and it can be removed by boiling. Second type of hardness is permanent hardness. This is due to the presence of calcium and magnesium in the form of chlorides and sulfates. Okay, due to the chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium. And this permanent hardness could not be removed by simple boiling. There are different methods to remove permanent hardness. Okay. So softening of water or removal of temporary hardness. Removal of temporary hardness. There are two methods to remove temporary hardness. First one is boiling. While boiling the solution, the hard water, what happens? Magnesium bicarbonate gets converted into magnesium hydroxide instead of magnesium carbonate. Okay, and calcium bicarbonate get converted into calcium carbonate. Okay, so these two precipitates are obtained. This can be removed by filtration. Okay, so magnesium bicarbonate on heating converted to magnesium hydroxide. Precipitate is obtained and carbon dioxide gas is evolved. Then calcium bicarbonate on heating gets converted into calcium carbonate. Precipitate is obtained, then H2O plus carbon dioxide gas is evolved. These precipitates can be removed by filtration. Now, second method is Clark's method. In this case, a calculated amount of lime or calcium hydroxide is added. Okay, so what happened to calcium bicarbonate? Calcium bicarbonate in hard water on reaction with calcium hydroxide gets converted to calcium carbonate, which is a precipitate, okay, and 2H2O. Okay, this can be removed by filtration. Similarly, magnesium bicarbonate present in the hard water on reaction with calcium hydroxide, calcium carbonate precipitate, then magnesium hydroxide precipitate and water is obtained. So these precipitates can be removed by filtration. Okay, these are the two methods to remove temporary hardness. If there are different methods for the removal of permanent hardness, Okay, so first method, treatment with washing soda. On treatment with washing soda, Na2CO3 or washing soda. Okay, when calculated amount of washing soda is added, chlorides and sulfates, permanent hardness is due to the presence of chlorides and sulfates. Chlorides and sulfates of calcium and magnesium are precipitated as they are insoluble carbonates. Okay, see the reaction. CaCl2 on reaction with calcium chloride, reaction with Na2CO3, what happens? Their carbonate CaCO3 gets precipitated and 2NaCl. Okay, next, magnesium sulfate present on reaction with Na2CO3. Again, what happens? MgCO3, magnesium carbonate, gets precipitated and Na2SO4. This will be the reaction. Okay, this gets precipitated and this can be removed and we will get soft water. Next, second method is Calgon's method. What is mean by Calgon? Calgon is the official name of Na6P6O18, that is Na6P6O18, which is sodium hexametaphosphate. This is commercially known as Calgon. Okay, sodium hexametaphosphate or Na6P6O18. Okay, with Calgon, with this compound, what happens? Calcium and magnesium salt give complex salt as follows. Okay, first Na6P6O18 ionizes and form 2Na plus Na4P6O18 2-. This compound will be obtained. This on reaction with the metals, calcium and magnesium metals present in the hard water. that is Na4P6O18, 2 minus, reacts with M2 plus. This means calcium and magnesium metal in the hard water gets converted to Na2MP6O18 2 minus plus 2Na plus. So a complex anion is obtained. Okay, this will keep Mg2 plus and Ca2 plus ions in the solution. Okay, so these are the two methods to remove permanent hardness. Now there are different methods for the removal of permanent hardness. Third method is ion exchange method. Third method, ion exchange method. In this case, we are using permutate or zeolite. Okay, zeolite or permutate is used. It's a compound called as sodium aluminium silicate. Okay, sodium aluminium silicate, that is NaAlSiO4. Sodium aluminium silicate is called as zeolite or permutate. So this process is also called as zeolite or permutate process. For simplicity, we can write like this, NaZ. Okay, so on reaction with hard water, what happens? The metal ions, calcium and magnesium ions present in the ion gets exchanged by NaZ. That is NaZ reaction with M2 plus. This is magnesium or calcium and form, what happens? MZ2 plus 2Na plus. Okay, so as the reaction proceeds, what happens? Zeolites get exhausted and there will be no zeolite. So in that case, we can regenerate zeolite by adding aqueous NaCl solution. Okay, and the reaction will be like this, this MZ2 on reaction with NaCl solution, aqueous NaCl solution gets converted into 2NaZ is regenerated. Okay, and MCl2. So the reaction continues. Okay, this reaction, so this process is called as ion exchange method.